The 46-year-old Stanley Kisambira, a driver attached to the judiciary, had earlier been remanded to Luzira Prison on a holding charge of offensive communication. However, yesterday, the head of the Wildlife and Utilities Court issued a production warranty demanding Kisambira's production in court. As he appeared before Chief Magistrate Gladys Kamasanyu, Kisambira was formally charged with promoting hate speech. He pleaded not guilty to the charge and went ahead and applied for bail.
And that a driver can decide to cause road accidents by ramming into a moving truck, thereby killing the judges. So, what do you plead? All right, so I have entered a plea of not guilty against each person.
After examining Kisambira's grounds for the bail application and the sureties he presented in court, Gladys Kamasanyu granted him a 10 million shillings non-cash bail.
And we pray for a non-cash bond for the accused person on the basis of the 235,000 shillings that he receives as salary. And Your Honor, in addition, the accused person has three sureties.
His sureties were each bonded 5 million shillings, also not cash. Kisambira was ordered to return to court on June 12th for further mention of his case.
The accused person, having presented substantial sureties before a court, charged with an offence that is bailable by this court, still presumed to be innocent until the state adduces evidence to prove him guilty. He's given a chance to answer the charge from home as opposed to coming from prison. He's therefore today granted bail.
Kisambira's woes started after an audio recording in which he was expressing his dissatisfaction about his low salary went viral on social media. Prosecution states that Kisambira on May 12, 2023 within Uganda through a computer shared on the Judiciary Transport WhatsApp group information to wit the recorded audio which was likely to promote hostility against judges in the judiciary. In the clip, he complained that the judges' salaries are unfairly over and above those of their drivers and that a driver can decide to cause road accidents by ramming into a moving truck, thereby killing the judges and their bodyguards.
Would want this to be a political discussion, a discussion on how we treat the drivers, how we treat the court clerks, how we treat other people subordinate in the judiciary system.
Kisambira, who was first detained last week before he was days later released on police bond, was rearrested on Monday morning when he went to report himself at Kampala Central Police Station. In the audio recording, Kisambira, who has been driving Justice Geoffrey Namundi, who is a judge in Mbale District, said 235,000 shillings monthly salary was not enough to cater for his family needs. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.